Hi, my name is Justin Lussier from PROAnalytics, located in New Jersey. PROAnalytics is a company focused on distributing process analytics equipment for the biotech market. And today I'd like to tell you a little bit about RANDOX Laboratories. RANDOX is a company headquartered globally in Northern Ireland and headquartered in the US in West Virginia. They are a company that's offering automated photometric biochemistry analyzers for bioprocessing. These are analyzers that are optically based, and because they are optical, they are doing a measurement that is very accurate and very repeatable. The measurement is essentially pipetting a little bit of sample into a cuvette, pipetting a little bit of a reagent into a cuvette. The reagent is specific for each metabolite. An enzymatic reaction occurs within that cuvette, and then a color is created based upon that enzymatic reaction. With a colorimetric measurement at a specific optical frequency, the color is determined to a specific concentration, and it's correlated to a metabolite concentration. The instrument is very easy to use, very low maintenance, and the data is very robust and repeatable. Following, I can give you a little bit of an overview on the hardware and the menu structure of the software. I can now give you a brief overview of the hardware. If we open up the lid of the instrument, you're going to see that there's two pipetting arms, one mixer. Underneath here is where all the cuvettes are stored. And then we have two chambers here. One is for the reagents. So each bottle itself would be for a specific reagent. And they're barcoded. And we just place the barcode out. And when we put it into the chamber, with a click of a button, the instrument will automatically recognize what reagents are on board. Over here are the samples. You put your samples into standard sample cups. Various instruments have various sizes, mostly depending on the throughput, but they also have different numbers of samples. So when we run the instrument, this first pipetter is going to pick up a little bit of sample and put it into a cuvette. The second pipetter is going to pick up a little bit of reagent and put it into the cuvette. The mixer is going to mix the cuvette. An enzymatic reaction occurs, creating a color. And then that color is measured and correlated very accurately to a specific metabolite concentration. I can now tell you a little bit about the user interface for the RANDOX system. This screen here is under the run monitor. It's called the run monitor screen. It just gives you a basic overview about where the sample status stands. Under test selection, you would enter in all of your samples, whether it be an unknown sample or a normal sample type. If you wanted more advanced information about what the machine is doing in the background, chemistry parameters will tell you all about each specific metabolite, what its measurement units are, how much sample and how much reagent is being put into the cuvette, and what specific optical frequency the measurement is being done at. But this is all things that are being done in the background of the instrument. Under calibration, you'll have your calibration curves, and under parameters, you're able to enter in your calibrator values. If we go back to run monitor and we go to inventory, this is an area where it will tell you, based upon the barcodes, it'll tell you the position of each reagent bottle. It'll tell you the reagent type, lactate, for example. It'll tell you the reagent manufacturer's lot number, how much volume is left inside of that bottle, how many more tests can be done based upon that volume. And it'll also tell you the barcode name right here. So each bottle will have its own barcode. And then it'll tell you not only the expiration date, but its onboard stability. So how many more days it can be run before it needs to be calibrated or discarded. If we go back to the test selection area, you have 40 sample positions here. All you have to do is highlight a specific position. You can put your sample cups anywhere you prefer. Let's just say, for example, we were going to run a calibration and we were going to run it in position number 22. Over here, you have the sample types. So N is for normal sample type. S is for a calibration of a single metabolites. MS is for multiple metabolites calibration. Over here you have the specific name of each calibrator that could be on board. Once you select the name, you just click the save button and you'll see it automatically populated two positions. The first one is always going to be the 0 point, which is water or saline. And then the second point is always going to be the calibrator material itself, which comes from the manufacturer. It comes in a liquid form that's in a bottle. And inside of this box comes a data sheet. And the data sheet tells you the exact concentration of this calibrator material. So from that data sheet that comes with the calibrator material, if we simply go to calibration and then we go to parameters, here we can enter in 0, which is going to be the water or the saline. And here is where we enter the value from the data sheet. So in this example, the glucose calibrator material concentration that came from the manufacturer designates on the data sheet that the value is 2.63. Once you have all that loaded, you can go to the next position. Let's say, for example, we wanted to run a normal sample type and we wanted to run it for glucose. Here we can name the sample. Let's just say we wanted to name it test one. Then when you save the position, you can see it automatically goes to the next position and it's ready for you to load the next sample and automatically increases the last digit from 1 to 2. So it sequentially names the sample, and then you would just have to go select your metabolites and click save. So it's essentially two buttons to run the samples. So again, in position number 22, for example, we have a calibration, a multi-calibration. So that's going to calibrate multiple metabolites that are on board. You have the 0 point, and then you have the calibrator material. So again, position number 22 is water. Position number 23 is going to be the calibrator material. And then positions number 24, 25, and 26 are going to be samples of unknown concentration, so they're normal sample type, and they're going to be tested for glucose. So this position is called test number one. Then it automatically named the next position test number two. And we select glucose to be the metabolite to be tested. And then in the next position, we have test number three is the sample name, going to be run for glucose. So it automatically names the samples, it increases the number by one digit. If you wanted to change that, you could of course just type it in. And then here are the sample cups that are used. This is your basic sample cup. This is gonna be your deionized water. I'll put some of the calibrator material in here for the two positions. And then we'll load on positions number 24, 25, and 26 with sample cups of unknown concentration, and those are going to be tested for glucose. So this is the instrument in operation mode. On the right-hand side moving, you see that the sample pipetting arm is moving. On the left-hand side now, you see that the reagent pipetting arm is moving. So those two work together. The right arm pipetting sample into a cuvette, the left arm pipetting reagent into a cuvette. And then in the rear, there's a mixing paddle, which mixes the cuvette. And then those two materials, the sample and the reagent, create an enzymatic reaction, and then that creates a color. The color is then measured and correlated very accurately to a metabolite concentration. There you see in the back, the mixing arm is springing into action, doing some mixing, and going back to its wash position. The left arm is pipetting some reagent right now, going back to its wash position. And in the back spinning is the incubation reaction chamber. So all the cuvettes are down below the instrument deck, and those are being held at a steady temperature where the enzymatic reaction is occurring. This here is simply another view of the instrument running, and you can see in the back there are the cuvettes within the incubation reaction chamber, as long as another view of all of its washing station. So as the instrument is running, we can take a look at the software and we may be able to see that four positions so far have been initiated. Two of them are green, two of them are white. Green indicates that the sampling has already started. White indicates that the sample has not been processed yet. So out of the five samples, two of them are green and three of them are white. As the instrument progresses with its measurements, more and more samples will turn green, and then once it's completed, it will turn a turquoise color. Okay, so let's say that you'd like to change out a reagent bottle. Each reagent bottle generally is 20 milliliters, and that can do about 100 samples. Let's say you've run 100 samples for a particular reagent, and that reagent bottle has become empty. So what we're gonna do is just open up the lid here, take off the cover for the reaction chamber unit. Inside is gonna be all of your reagent bottles. So what you're gonna do is simply take out the one that's empty. You're gonna have a box of new reagents here. This one happens to be for glucose, has four bottles in it. Each bottle is 20 milliliters. Like we said, that's good for about 100 samples. You simply place it into the reagent chamber, barcode facing out. When you press a single button on the computer, what's gonna happen is it's gonna rotate and scan every single barcode that's on here. And it's gonna recognize just through the barcode that there's a new reagent on board. It's gonna recognize through that barcode the reagent bottle size, how many samples can be run, what the expiration date is, and how many days it can be on board before it needs to be calibrated or discarded. So always make sure you take the cap off before you place it on board. And then you place the carousel back into the unit, affix the lid, and that's it. Okay, so now your run is complete, and you're looking to export the data. So that is under the System Parameters tab, and on the bottom you click on the Results sub-tab. And if I just click Search, it's going to come up with the three tests that we did on our last run. I just used the pre-populated data, but if you wanted to, you could do some more advanced search, such as dates. You could do searching by name of the sample, various advanced search parameters. So we ran three tests. On test one, the glucose result was 6.55. On test two, the glucose result was 6.14. And on test three, it was 6.14. So if we had run glutamine or glutamate or ammonia or lactate, those would be shown in these columns here. So we just did a data search and we display the data on the screen here. There's a couple different options. You can display it only on the screen. You could display it on the screen and print it. That would be a standard 8.5 by 11 printer. Or you could display it on the screen and export it to a flash drive. So that would be a USB thumb drive that you put into the computer. So if we select flash disk, and then we click search, it's gonna show up the same as the on the screen here. But what's gonna happen is that on your USB stick that you have in the computer, there's gonna be a CSV file created. And that CSV file is going to be able to be opened in Excel, and your data is going to be ready to be viewed on a different computer. Well, I wanted to thank you very sincerely for watching. We really appreciate your time. Once again, my name is Justin Lussier from PROAnalytics out of New Jersey. We're the representative for RANDOX Laboratories, who's offering the photometric biochemistry analyzer for biotech markets. Just to recap, this is an instrument that has a very nice user interface, very easy to use, very easy to learn how to use, has very, very low maintenance, very, very accurate, reproducible data, and overall it's a very fast system, does fast measurements for high throughput applications. So once again, thank you for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to visit our website, look us up. Our website is www.pro-analytics.net. And we sincerely look forward to hearing from you. Thank you very much.